Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. A while back I made a video showing how I made this trigger mechanism prototype for a Speargun. At the time I used the aluminum just to speed up all the cutting and the drilling. The goal there was to see all the parts moving together. Today I'm gonna make the same trigger mechanism but using all stainless steel, and once it's finished will be a full functional trigger good to be used on any homemade Speargun project. So let's start.
Got the material ready to go. That's a 2 millimeter thick. That's for the housing, it's all stainless steel. The tubing is 30 by 15, 1.5 millimeters wall thickness, also for the housing. This bar, it's 5 millimeters thick, will be used for the sear and the trigger. These rods are 4 and 5 millimeters diameter and will be used to cut the pins that hold everything together inside the housing. I already cut this square piece with a hacksaw. That's a 65 millimeters from 65 from the 2 millimeter thick material. Next, I'm gonna glue, transfer, and drill all of these holes with a 4 millimeter drill. The holes will help the bending process because this is quite thick, it's 2 millimeters, and without the holes and without any machinery, it will be very difficult to make such a bend because it will be like a 90 degree two times. And that will become the housing. With the center punch, I'm gonna transfer all of these holes so I can drill it with a 4 millimeter drill. Got the housing plate set up on the drill press machine. With the 4 millimeter drill, I'm gonna start drilling all of these holes. I drilled the first 9 holes, so I'm gonna move to the next row and drill 9 more. And the last one. A little bit of oil. Lifting the drill to break the chip. And we're done. There's the holes all drilled out. This side doesn't look too bad. The back side, there's a different story. This stainless steel is quite empty. It's a very gummy material, tough to drill. So now I have these big, tall burrs. And the plan here is to use a chamfer tool. I'm gonna try this one. And go on every single hole and make a small chamfer. And hopefully this will clean up the burrs and look good. There's my small drill press machine all set up to chamfer those 4 millimeter holes to remove the burrs. Actually, I have an X and Y cross table mounted on it, and sometimes I use this setup as a milling machine. Okay, all done. There's the housing plate ready for bending. After the chamfering, I polish it up a little bit with some sandpaper. On the inside, with the scriber, I made a couple lines along the holes, and these will be guidelines for the bending. Clamped the housing plate on this vise, put some masking tape on it to protect it so it doesn't scratch it too much. Now I have two more clamps holding the housing plate against this bar. And next I'm gonna start moving everything together this way. Very happy with the results so far. I still have one more bend to do, but everything looks very good. The inside, it's very clean, very sharp down here. And on the top, this radius, it's not too big either. To make the second bend, I'm gonna use this 9mm thick plate, clamp everything together on the vise, and then bend this side down to create the housing. On the belt sander, I'm gonna grind all the sides square to each other and down to the final size, which is 65 by 30 millimeters. Check this out. I just have a word to describe this. Beautiful. And you know what? These holes on the top, they just look amazing. It reminds me of a muffler from a racing car. I think this is going to be like the coolest looking trigger mechanism on YouTube. There's a much easier way to make a trigger housing. From this square tubing, it's 30 by 15. By 1.5 millimeters wall thickness. I cut off a piece and I end up with something like this. On this one, I left this tab. It doesn't do anything, just for looks. I may put a screw hole on the top. And once I transfer and drill all the side holes for the pins, I just have to cut the bottom off, file everything down, get everything on size, and the housing is done. Before I transfer and drill all of these holes, I want to explain something. All of the holes are drilled through both walls, except this one. It's a viewing port to look into the mechanism. Once the trigger and the Sear are engaged, I can look through, and if there's any mismatch, I can adjust it as needed. I cut this piece of wood. Once I slide it inside the housing, it will prevent the walls from collapsing when I center punch all of the holes. And it will keep the drill perpendicular to both walls, especially when it starts to drill the bottom side. To prevent drilling holes oversize, I'll use three drills for each hole. I have a 2.5mm, 3.8 and 4mm drill for the 4mm hole, and I'll use 2.5mm, 4.8 and 5mm drill to drill the 5mm holes.
3.8 to drill. And the last drill, it's 4 millimeters. I'm checking the hole size with the 4 millimeter pin. It's pretty good. It's actually a press fit, a slightly press fit. And this way the pin will stay in place all the time. I finished drilling and chamfering all the holes. Now with a hacksaw, I'll cut off the bottom side. Trigger housing almost finished. While I was filing those steps down, I thought that it may be a good thing to have those steps there. It will make a much stronger wall. And next time, instead of cutting off the whole bottom, I'm going to leave a little bit of material right in the middle, like a bridge connecting the two walls. And that will prevent the walls from flexing, because right now they're flexing a little bit, not much. And that will make a much stronger trigger housing. For now, there's only one thing left to do. I'm going to jewel the whole thing, sides, top, and I think it's going to look just amazing. To make the jewels, I'm using a 6 millimeter abrasive rod. I move 3 millimeters and hold it for about 3 seconds. Move 3 millimeters, hold it 3 seconds. Thank you.
finished the housings and they're looking just amazing. Check this out. And this one, the jewels. It was that extra step, but what a difference it made. Now it's time to start working on the sear, the trigger, put the whole thing together, and we got a trigger mechanism done. Let's go.